Go into the first store you see in the sewer and get the broken iron out of the trash can. Going left from the start will net you a croissant. You'll fight the deadly mice a lot in the sewer. They have a high critical hit ratio, and if they gang up on you, you're virtually dead where you stand. The stinky ghosts can be pains in the neck to beat, since not only can they possess you, but they also possess high physical defense, thereby forcing you to use your psychic power. Find a broken spray can in this room. If you think there's a magic butterfly room in the sewer, you'd be right. And you'll find it right here. You'll be able to find a Rust Promoter DX to the left of the Magic Butterfly Room. In the last room before the boss, you can get the Broken Bazooka. Once Jeff is able to fix the Broken Bazooka, it will become his new primary weapon. Now that you've gotten the Broken Bazooka, it's now time to go for Sanctuary number 5. Make sure you are healed up before the battle, because this boss is tough. What makes the Plague Grab Goon so tough to defeat is his ability to land critical hits and poison all in one attack. He'll also do it often. You can counter this by using Flash Beta to blind him, and if you're really lucky, Flash Beta can knock him out in one shot. The key to winning this battle is keeping your energy up and unleashing a constant barrage of attacks. Before leaving Magna Hill, make sure you grab the carrot key on the way out. With business and foresight complete, teleport to Delon. The last time you were here, you may have noticed some statues guarding a cave in the southwestern part of the lawn. Head there now with the carrot key. What were those statues guarding? Find out in the next episode.